You mentioned a lot of other great artists that you've been able to collaborate with over the years. What excites you about music that you hear on the radio, music, if you even listen to the radio or online or wherever it might be, what gets you excited about music?
Look, I guess, yeah, that's a good question. It's hard to define, really. Unfortunately for me, sometimes I feel like I'm getting a bit older or something, but there's a lot of music out there that doesn't really excite me a lot, and I'm not really sure whether that's a cultural thing, whether culturally we've moved into an area where, people are writing a lot of pretty safe music, I think. Yeah, anything that gets me excited is something that, I feel is pushing boundaries in certain areas that I enjoy without necessarily making something different just for the sake of it. There's a lot of new sounds out there. There's a lot of music coming out of computers, and I find a lot of that very samey, a little bit sterile in a lot of ways. So, yeah, I guess the psychedelic end of music is probably interesting me more than it did, earlier in my career, where I was probably more sort of soul funk orientated. These days, I'd rather go and hear a psych band while out.
Are you going back in time with some of that music, or listening to more like the King Gizzard and Lizard Wizard and some of the newer bands that are doing all that?
Yeah, I mean, time doesn't play a big role in what excites me in that respect. I think, the odder the music is, for me these days, I find it more exciting. So, if I on the listening to old stuff sort of tip, or even new stuff, if someone's gone and made a synthesizer and playing some kind of crazy wacky music on a homemade bit of gear, that's sort of more exciting to me than hearing, someone writing something in Ableton that sounds kind of like the next guy's record, because they're all using, the same plugins and all that type of jazz. So, yeah, just pushing the boundaries a little bit more.
Could we ever see you doing a psychedelic record
I'd
and
love to. I was talking again off air about sort of the next chapter of my studio will probably be moving to a bigger space, and I hope to produce a couple of bands that are doing that style of music, because I think I could bring something to it, and I think it'd be really exciting to work with some guys that were, on that tip. So yeah, without a doubt, I think you could hear a psychedelic Catalyst inspired record in the future.
Very cool. And we were also talking quite a bit about festivals and overseas and of the ones that you've played, do you have a favorite festival? What makes it kind of stick out from the rest?
Yeah, well, I haven't done a lot of international festivals, and that might be something I do with this next Quakers record, because there was quite a demand in Europe after the first one, but the situation wasn't really right for me to sort of put the energy into that at the time. And Jeff's obviously got Porter's Head and his sort of kraut rock thing that he does called Beak, and a few other side projects. He's been doing a few soundtrack things, so he's not really going to be at the helm of it. But Australia wise, I'd have to say that Splendour's probably my favourite festival. I love the area up around Byron and that sort of thing, but those guys put on such a great festival for the artists and the punters. And had a lot of experience. I think Jessica was originally sort of involved with Homebake and things back in the day. So, they've definitely cut their teeth a long time ago, and have got it running pretty smoothly now. And I just spoke to some of my friends that frequented the festival just gone this weekend, and they said, it was really well organized and everyone had a great time. They'd ironed out the hiccups of the new sort of venue that they're inhabiting up in the North Byron Parklands, I call it. I think they call it. So yeah, I'd have to put that down as number one.
And you've played it, of course, over the years.
Yeah, I've played a few Splendours. I played as Space Invaders was the last time we played, I think in 2011, and we had a great setup there. And I've played as Catalyst two or three times over the years. So hopefully they'll get me back as one of these incarnations again.
I'm sure it won't be too long. I mean, by the sounds of it, there's so much you're working on. It's anyone's guess which project will be next.
Yeah, it's funny. I don't really. Sometimes it feels like I'm not doing much, and then I sort of go about listing the things that I've been working on, and I realize that there is a fair bit going on. Yeah, so there'll be at least three releases out in the next 12 months. because I've got three of those records, as we mentioned earlier, pretty much wrapped up. Next Quakers is probably about, you know, 60-70% done. You know, the rappers have got their beats now. I've just got to whip them over the internet to to get the verses back, and you know, get deal with Jeff a little bit and fine tune it, and that's kind of done. The record with Guilty's, you know, pretty much a wrap. He arrives here on Thursday, and obviously when we've got a bit of time out next week in between the shows, we'll just run through it and, you know, check his feeling, all the changes and different additional production that I've done since he heard it last, and pretty much hand that in. So keep it busy.
Those should be good shows as well.
I'm looking forward to it, man. Yeah, he's really great live. He sounds very much like he does on the record, and I think he's a very authentic kind of MC. And when I first saw him live, I didn't really know much about him or who he was, and it was just one of those situations where I happened to be at a venue in Amsterdam, this sort of Heineken show that they'd put on, and someone had invited me to, and it was quite an elaborate setup where Wajid and his band played in the middle of this venue, and they had four different producers taking the stems from the live set and doing a live remix, Black Milk, one of the guys from Four Hero, and a couple of other producers, and then downstairs in between them doing the live set, Wajid playing and the remixes being played, Guilty performed downstairs, and I was quite mesmerised, and I was staying with Jeff in Bristol at the time, and went back and just went, man, I saw this guy Guilty Simpson, you know, he was awesome. And not long after that we started the Quakers, so he was one of the first people we earmarked to get on.
That's where it's the origins of that story.
Exactly. So yeah, really looking forward to getting out, playing a couple of the new tunes that we've been working on, which will be exciting, and backing him up for some of the stuff that sort of made him famous over the years, some of the classics he's written with Jay Diller and, you know, other legendary producers. So it's an honour in a sense.